As an employee at the not-so-accessible organization, you have decided to steer things right. But how do you accomplish that? In this video, you will learn how to transfer your organization from a state where nobody cares about accessibility to a state where working with accessibility will be as natural as eating and breathing. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Ilyas Benani. I have been working with IT accessibility since 1993, mostly as a developer along with user testing and accessible PDF documents, just to name a few things. I have done almost everything you can think of when it comes to IT and accessibility. Throughout the years, I have witnessed several examples of how people, despite their best intentions and with the greatest prerequisites, have made their customers or colleagues become opposed to working with accessibility. Sad to admit, but I have also made a few of those mistakes that I'd like to share, as well as some really successful ideas that turned out to work really well. So, let's talk about how to shift the culture of a whole workplace to a state where colleagues begin to compete to design and build the most accessible services. Or, to put it in a one-liner you'll be more likely to remember, from nobody cares to natively curious. What is accessibility? We all know that accessibility is the same as inclusion. Everybody has the right to use websites, apps, and read documents, etc. What's good for some does benefit all of us at the end of the day, and so on. All those things are of course true if you only take the user's perspective. But there is more to discuss here, since there's a few other stakeholders you need to take into account. Let's change the subject for a while and talk about resources. Everything in our life is about resources. It doesn't matter if it's financial resources, as in money and assets, natural resources, as in air, water, and food, or personal resources, as in physical and mental abilities. No matter what you do or where you are, you will always be in either one of these three situations. 1. Gaining resources. 2. Spending resources wisely. 3. Losing resources. The first two situations are good for all of us, but the last one is what most of us will do everything to avoid. This applies both to yourself as a human being, as well as to the organization whose way of working you want to change. When you first approach an organization with the idea of accessibility, the reply will most likely be a pure and non-negotiable no. The reason behind this strange behavior is that your claims are interpreted by the organization as if they will most likely never benefit from this new thing called accessibility. The organization feels like you will put them in the state of losing resources, so in order to survive, the organization will have to deny your request. Instead of losing resources, there must be a way for the organization to gain resources, or at least spend their resources wisely and still be accessible. Therefore, in order to succeed, you'll have to come up with an idea of how the organization might benefit from this accessibility thing. The question you'll have to answer is, what's in it for them? You'll have to change the point of view from the user's perspective to the provider's perspective, but more on that later. Things you cannot do. Before we discuss what you actually can do in order to succeed, let's spend a few minutes talking about things you really should avoid. Trust me, I have seen this several times and, as I mentioned in the beginning of this video, I have made these mistakes myself. Make yourself Mr. Accessibility. Or Mrs. That's not so good either. It might be very tempting to consider yourself as the expert, the one with the most experience and knowledge. People around you should just listen and do what you tell them to. After all, you're the expert, right? Your coworkers will most likely have several points of view you as the accessibility expert did not think of in the first place. By listening to and discussing with your coworkers and learning from their experiences, you will be more likely to find the answer to the question of how the organization will benefit from applying accessibility. So, avoid being that arrogant expert and try to be more humble and compassionate. Threaten with the law. In the EU, we have had accessibility laws since 2018, EN 301/549, that has been ratified by the laws of all member states. Okay, that's a bit simplified, but you get the idea. If your organization defies the law, They will be subject to sanctions such as penalty fees. Since nobody wants to lose resources, the organization will probably do anything in order to avoid those penalty fees, right? Well, think again. If the organization gets caught breaking that accessibility law, the supervisory authority will give the organization enough time to address these issues long before any penalty fees are ruled out in court. Now, let's look at things you can do. Aside of things you really should avoid, there are of course several things you can do in order to make accessibility a natural part of the culture and workflow of your organization. What's in it for the recipient? This is the question you'll have to answer before you do anything else. You'll have to find out the benefits for the recipient, which in this case is the organization you urge to convince. So, what are those benefits? You're probably already aware of many of them, but let me point out some of the most common ones. Increased sales. By applying accessibility to your website, app, or any other way wherever your customers might do their purchases, the customers, their relatives, friends, and other people they know will choose you in favor of your not-so-accessible competitors. One might say that the necessary changes are too expensive and therefore do not meet the benefits. If that's the case, the organization has done a quite crappy product in the first place. If your organization is aware of that, chances are that your competitors are also aware of your situation and they might try to take advantage of your shortcomings. High quality code and therefore better SEO ranking. This one is a bit unexpected to most of us, but when your services are more accessible, that also means that the code behind those services is better written and therefore also easier and less expensive to maintain. More accessible code also means increased chances of a higher ranking on Google searches. So, by pointing out as many benefits for your organization, i.e. increase their resources, you will more likely be able to succeed in convincing them why accessibility is a good thing. Find other stakeholders. Now, when you have pointed out the benefits for your organization, it is time to team up with other persons who also share those goals. They might not be much into accessibility, but since you all share the same goals, you might also be interested in the same methods of reaching those goals. Potential stakeholders might be the CIO of your company, all the sales personnel, and hopefully also the development teams. Hire talented persons who themselves do benefit from accessible products and services. This is a simple trick to apply when you want to change the mindset of the entire organization. By employing someone very talented who's also in need of assistive technology, you will soon realize that accessibility becomes a natural thing for all your coworkers. This will also affect the development of your products and services, since no one would like to harm a valued coworker, especially if that coworker happens to be your new boss. Hire people more experienced than yourself. This might seem to contradict what I just said. If you hire somebody who is more experienced than you, wouldn't that person pass you as an expert? You don't want to end up in the accessibility graveyard where no one is asking for your services. Well, my experience is quite the opposite, actually. When you are working with someone more talented than yourself, his or her knowledge tends to spill over to you. Together, you will establish a workflow and an acceptance for accessibility far greater than you could ever do by yourself. Join the T12T community. If nothing of the above is working, you can always seek assistance from the T12T community. Here you will find the most talented accessibility experts in Sweden, ready to assist you in whatever issue you might need help with. Join the public Slack at t12t.se. Well, those are my best suggestions of how you should act in order to renew the mindset of your organization, from nobody cares to natively curious. And one more thing before we end this video. Thank you for listening.